In this video, we're going to take a look at this exhaust gas analyzer. Okay, so the brand of this unit is KAL Equip. Model number is R-89. So I purchased this unit secondhand a while ago. I've used it a few times. And the reason why this is useful, it's to make sure you've got your mixture adjusted right, your air-fuel mixture. The way it works, this end of the rubber hose, that goes into the exhaust pipe. The other end of that rubber hose connects onto the end of this sensor. And then that sensor is connected to this device here, which will show the mixture, whether it's rich or lean. So let's get started and have a look at the instructions. So the instructions sort of just give a bit of like a safety overview there. They sort of explain how to use it, connect it up when the engine's warm, because a cold engine, obviously, the emissions are going to be different compared to when it is running at temperature. There's some information here about the ratios of air fuel. So these ratios show the amount of carbon dioxide percentage based on the ratio of air-fuel mixture. And there's a few other parameters in here for just different vehicles as a guideline. It goes on to explain how to adjust the fuel ratio in your carburetor. So all cars are going to be different. What else have we got on here? Yeah, a few other bits and pieces here, but that's about it. So let's unhook it up and then see how it goes. So the first step we need to do is connect this end of the rubber hose into the exhaust. Just like that is sufficient. Then this end of the rubber hose needs to go onto the sensor. So there's going to be various different ways you can attach this. There is a magnet on there, depending on what you're able to do with it though. Just for simplicity, I'm not going to do up that buckle. That's going to be sufficient. I'm not going to be driving the car anywhere with this attached. So on the actual unit itself, there's two leads. So this one lead goes to some alligator terminals, which connect up to a power supply. And then of course, this other lead is leading to the sensor. Now on the actual unit, what you need to do is you need to initialize it. At the moment, it's not connected, and the needle on there, it's a little bit before this set mark. So you'll see there's a bit of text that says set. You just need to use a screwdriver and adjust this needle so it is in the set position. So the next step now is to then connect this up to the a power supply. And then again, the needle will move. You still need to adjust this set control knob to get the needle in the center back to the set position. So let me connect this up to the power. When we connect up this, we need to connect up the positive first. I always just like to connect it to the solenoid. I'm just actually connecting it to where the actual battery cable is connected to. And then the other point will just be anywhere where I can get a good earth. So at the moment, that meter will have power to it. Now that the meter has got power to it, you can turn this black set control knob just to fine tune it, because you want that needle in the 12 o'clock position, or where it's pointing to set. So once it's there, we're pretty much ready to start it up. It's a bad reflection on there, I don't know how well you can see that, but then the needle is pointing straight up. So now we can start it and see. So where it says idle zone, we should be over here somewhere. Now, just while I start it, I'll place the camera down here so you can get a good view of the actual readout. I'll try and get this as clear as I can. So of course if your mixture isn't correct on idle, you can adjust it. I'm not going to show you how to adjust the carbs in this video. You can have a look at that, I'm sure that you'll find a video how to do that. So hopefully that's sort of just giving you a look at how to use one of these. There are newer versions of these, ones that just get your power from the cigarette lighter, go to the exhaust, so they're a lot simpler. But this unit seems to work all right. All right, I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching my videos.